Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to go back to the year 2000, and I'm going to be reviewing No Doubt's fourth album, The Return of Saturn. The Return of Saturn was released 18 years ago on this date, so today is the anniversary of this album. And when I think of this album, I think of the late 90s and early 2000s. It gives me a nostalgic type of feel. It reminds me a lot of Nickelodeon. It reminds me a lot of Pizza Hut. I don't know if you guys remember the old school Pizza Hut. I used to eat there a lot when I was younger, and I could just whenever I think of this album and this particular time, I think of Pizza Hut, and I think of how good it was back then. And of course, everybody was really sporty at that time too, and it was really peaceful. I guess since it was the start of the new millennium, let's just say it was kind of it still kind of had like 90s influences. And during this time period, Gwen Stefani dyed her hair pink, which was her entire look for this album. And a couple of other artists also had pink hair. I think Shakira also had pink hair in the late 90s and early 2000s, and of course the artist Pink, and Christina Aguilera, and just a lot of pop artists that came out of this time, they had a lot of pink hair. This is one of my favorite No Doubt albums, and it's also a very underrated one. This was released right after Tragic Kingdom and before Rocksteady, which that album became their ticket to the mainstream. I previously owned this album on CD, as you can see here. So I went out of my way to purchase the vinyl of the album because I just wanted to see if it was any different from the CD or not. And that's one of the reasons why I purchased it, because this is my favorite No Doubt album. And because I have my record player here, I just wanted to give it a try. So I'm going to be opening this vinyl record and playing it for you guys, and at the same time reviewing it. So let's go. So I opened this and I took it out of the shrink wrap, and here is the vinyl cover. This is one of the best covers that No Doubt has ever done. It's very beautiful and very memorable, very spacey. And this is the back. I bought this brand new. And let's see what it has inside. So it has the record here. It's still in this envelope. And we have to get the cover art out. And this is the cover art, the same as the CD. It has two sides. I love this picture of her. This is the back. It has the lyrics of all the songs. I really miss this era. I really miss those days, guys. And see Saturn? Here it is. So I don't know if you guys are fans of astrology, or if you're into astrology, or if you're into any of that stuff. And astrology plays a big role in this album. And the reason why it's called The Return of Saturn is because it actually has to deal with a phenomenon called The Return of Saturn. So The Return of Saturn is a phenomenon in astrology, which every 27 to 29 years, Saturn returns to the sign it was when you were born, and it is a passage to adulthood. It takes approximately 29.5 years for Saturn to complete one full orbit around the sun and return to the same zodiac sign it was in when you were born. So when a person is in their late 20s, that's when they are experiencing their own return of Saturn, and they start to see things through a different perspective, and they start to figure out who they are, figure out what their purpose in life is, and they start to basically mature. And the return of Saturn is sort of a passage to the next level of adulthood. So according to astrologists, there's not only one return of Saturn, which happens in your late 20s. There's actually many return of Saturns that can occur in your life. For example, when you're in your 50s, maybe when you're middle age, that's when another return of Saturn can happen. Or when you're in your 70s, when you're an old wrinkled prune, and you can have another return of Saturn. So you're not only going to have one, you can have many in your life, which can attribute to maturity, wisdom, discovery, and other things that happen during the human experience. Now I'll be giving you a little bit of a background info on this album and the production, because this is one of my favorite albums, and unfortunately it's not one of No Doubt's popular albums. It was made during a time of transition in Gwen Stefani's life. There were a lot of events in Gwen Stefani's own Return of Saturn which inspired her to write these meaningful lyrics, and I guess she was on the road to self-discovery, and I guess this album sort of shows that. Their previous album, Tragic Kingdom, focused a lot on the relationship that went on between Gwen Stefani and her bassist, Tony Connell, and their breakup. And Don't Speak was the most popular song on that album, and there were a lot of songs on that album that were really successful, and it's one of No Doubt's best records. And the one that came out after Return of Saturn, Rocksteady, sort of made them into a mainstream pop hit. It's very poppy, very dance hall, very reggae. It's not one of my favorite albums because that's when they turned all pop. So you sort of hear those new wave inspired sounds and influences, and as well as their ska and reggae influences. But I could probably say that this album is quite different from Tragic Kingdom. It's not very loud and angry like that album was. This is very, very, it's kind of a very interesting album because there are a lot of ballads in this album, a lot of new wave sounds, like I said before, and it's very alternative sounding. It's very, very, very dark album. This is probably one of their darkest albums that they've ever done. I heard that Gwen was very depressed during the making of this album, and she was sort of looking to the poet Sylvia Plath to write her songs, and she was also going through her own Return of Saturn because she was 30 at the time and she was transitioning. She was in that transitional phase. She was also in a relationship with her then-boyfriend, Gavin Rossdale. And she was inspired by their relationship, and she sort of wrote her feelings that arose in their relationship in this album. I guess you could say the songs in this album are mainly about Gwen Stefani longing for a domestic life, wanting to settle down, wanting to get married and have children, but at the same time wanting to be free and wanting to be selfish and wanting to be in her band. So she's kind of stuck in between having a career and getting married and settling down. And you can see that in the album cover. You see a wedding cake, you see lipstick, it's a very spacey vibe. So this album is a journey and a transition from one level to another one, to a more mature level. I really love her fashion sense during this era because she had that marvelous pink hair, and she also had some really, really weird outfit choices. She has those fuzzy little slippers, and she has just a lot of weird fashions during this time.
She wore a lot of pink and fuchsia and purple and just really wacky colors. And this album reminds me a lot of that time period where girls used to wear body glitter all over themselves and used to wear their hair like in butterfly clips. And I remember those days. Actually, it kind of brings me back to a time where in my area there used to be a Mandy's, and they used to have like all these flower clothes and just really, really nice fashions. I'm gonna tell you what my favorite tracks are. So for this album, there were three singles that came out. It was Ex-Girlfriend, Simple Kind of Life, and Bathwater. Those were the most popular ones. They wrote the song New was used for that movie Go with Sarah Polley. I don't know if you guys actually saw the movie. It came out in 1999. I highly recommend this movie. It's very nice and funny too. It's about cars. And there's a lot of piano work in this album as well. I really like Magic's in the Makeup. It's very synthy and new wavy. Artificial Sweetener, that's my favorite song too. I feel like I'm actually in space when I hear this one. And Too Late, this is a really depressing song about a relationship. I think she wrote this about her and Gavin Rosdale. And Dark Blue, this is also a very depressing song. One of the best songs I have ever heard in my life. It's very dark. And at the end, there's a beautiful piano version of Too Late at the end of the song. And Simple Kind of Life is also very good. I also saw the music video for that song. It's very creative. And it was directed by Sophie Mueller, of course. 6 Feet Under, Marry Me, Suspension Without Suspense. And also there are a lot of like Mexican influences in this album as well. Like especially when I hear Comforting Lie. Totally Red. So now I'm going to be playing this album on my record player. And let's see how it sounds. Now it's playing Artificial Sweetener, which is one of my favorite songs on this album. Here she's talking about her Return of Saturn. Pretty impressive for a brand new record player, don't you think? I haven't opened this record player like since 2 years ago.
I've been listening to music lately. Not records, for the most part. I hope you guys enjoyed this No Doubt Return of Saturn final record review. This is one of my favorite albums of theirs, and unfortunately it's not very popular. It is quite underrated. It's not as popular as Tragic Kingdom and Rocksteady, which came out after this one. Anyway, this is a very alternative rock album. A lot of meaningful lyrics there, a lot of beautiful poetry. And I just love the record cover. It's one of the best records they've ever made, and the best covers. And also, I'm totally in love with this Return of Saturn era Gwen Stefani. I love her fashion in this era. It's very spacey and just colorful, and it gives me the nostalgia feels. And I can't believe this record is 18 years. It's hard to believe it's almost 20 years. And it's hard to believe that it just seems like yesterday when this record came out. And of course, I love No Doubt, and I might do a video about them in the future because I have a lot to talk about. I have a lot of stuff from them. I have a lot of CDs from them, and I'll be doing a separate video in the future about them, so stay tuned for that. I also might do a lookbook on Gwen Stefani's Return of Saturn era and her fashions at the time. I might do a lookbook on that, and even a makeup tutorial, so I'm open to any ideas or any suggestions if you guys are interested in seeing that. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give me a like. Please comment as well, what is your favorite No Doubt album, and also tell me what's your favorite song from The Return of Saturn. And, of course, hit that subscribe button if you want to see more interesting content such as this one, or if you want me to talk about other retro or nostalgic topics, feel free to inbox me privately. Thanks for watching, and I hope you guys have a spacey day. Later.